As a warning sign that if you talk enough sense, then you'll lose your mind. And I'll use you as a focal point, so I don't lose sight.
A freak incident at a zoo while taking a picture nearly cost him his life when lions attacked through their cage.
My chest is pinned to the bars. My leg is pinned to the bars. The female has my leg and the male has my arm in his mouth.
An LDS missionary is recovering tonight at a hospital in Guatemala.
Oh, God. Normal morning for a missionary. Nothing unusual, I was just excited. We hopped on a bus. We had to hike down this dirt road, and it was actually really beautiful. There was a little river going through the zoo.
I was setting up my camera to take a picture of the lions and the whole zone.
The female lion had come around, and she was trying to figure out what was going on towards the back of the cage. The female lion reaches through the bars and grabs onto my calf and pulls my leg to the bar. The male lion comes over when I was focusing on my calf, and he grabs my hand that was on the bars, because my hands were on the bars. I was trying to pull away. Male grabs my hand and pulls my whole arm in. He was clawing and biting my arm. And I feel like I did what anyone would do in that situation. I just started punching the male lion in the face as hard as I could. Started gouging his eyeball with my thumb. At that same time, my companion, Elder Lopez, grabbed a stick or a pole and was able to shove it into the lion's mouth while I was gouging its eyeball, and it let go of my arm, and someone pulled me away at that time. I believe they had me for about a minute and a half. I was laying on the dirt and grass. They put me into the back of the ambulance, and that's when all the adrenaline's pretty much worn off. Everything was bouncing, my leg was hitting on the ground. After a while, I blacked out. I woke up 4 days later in Murray, Utah, in the big hospital there.
Hello, it's me, Paul. We're just in the hospital, and I'm feeling great right now. It's about the new time.
Next Wednesday, I have surgery again. I think it's on my arm. Probably for the last time. It's on my arm.
Right above the elbow.
And they're actually going to cut it off
right above the elbow.
That's the best option for prosthetics.
That's the first time I was conscious since I went into the hospital 4 days earlier in Esquipulas. I had 9 surgeries. The 9th surgery was the amputation. They did a lot of work on my leg, a lot of work on my hand, and my thumb, and of course my arm. This experience and this trial hasn't moved or shaken my faith at all. Some people have way harder mental struggles that they have to go through their whole life. Mine was just a 6-month period. And I have a motto, it could be worse. I never like to think of what I could have done. It does no good. I do get emotional about it occasionally. The thing I'm most sad about is not being able to throw my kids in the air. But besides that, not sad about much. Hopefully they'll be able to see that their dad did something hard, and it wasn't just because I was tough or I had a positive attitude. It was more than that. I think the advantage I have by having one arm on the doors isn't that people feel bad for me, but when they do ask me about what happened, I never bring it up, but when they ask me
I have an emotional connection with the person, and I feel like it solidifies the sale. Sales is extremely difficult, but at the same time, it's extremely rewarding.
Don't give up. Keep your head up. Keep your feet moving.
One of my main motivators is to have fun.
Because if you're just walking around just to make money, well, that's not very much motivation.
The harder I work, the more fun I can have, and hopefully some of my example rubs off for some of my guys. The harder you work, the luckier you get.
And to have that mindset that you can accomplish anything you put your mind to.